Hello everyone, this is Chapolini again with yet another shoutcast. Today I picked a 2-on-2. This game was recently uploaded onto RTS Sanctuary, and it's a 2-on-2 posted by Hell's Ravage, playing as Zeus. His teammate is an Ornus player named Mikhail Victor, and they're facing against two Ra's, if I believe correctly. Yes, and Ra does have the advantage that if played in team games, both players can benefit from their allies' rain. So they can basically have a double rain, and if they get farms early on, their opponents won't be able to really take advantage, while they'll have a double rain. And yes. The problem is getting farms up early does use up a lot of your gold, and on Ghost Lake we know that typically gold starving can be a problem, though this is a Ghost Lake where everyone seems to be having two gold mines, and they seem to have one large gold mine in their back, which should be easily defended, or somewhat easily defended, so that they could actually try to pull off the strategy and be fine. I'm not sure what the Zeus Orange team does have in mind. I mean, they could try to do a rush. I mean, Ornus is a good rusher, Zeus is a good rusher, and in team games that could be a viable strategy, though booming up could just be as viable, and Ornus does have the extra mobility with their gates, which is fairly useful in single player, in one-on-ones, but really useful in multiplayer, because you can always two-on-one your opponent, and the Ra's won't be able to really match that. They do have Shifting Sand, but that's only, you know, a one-way ticket. You don't know how to get back. So I don't know if they'll take advantage of that or not. And let's see anyways, what if we can deduce what any of the players are going to do. I guess the Ornus player going for hunting dogs, our Greek player has gone for hunting dogs as well, I assume. Yes, I'm not sure about the Ra player. No, he went for husbandry instead. I mean, Ghost Lake always has a lot of sheep, so yes, you might as well. I mean, Influenza does have some hunt here. Well, a lone buffalo, and not that much hunt really, so I guess going for husbandry straight away isn't a bad idea. Though you will need to do a bit more scouting, find a bit more sheep, well, all of which are here in the middle, before husbandry is really worth it this early on. His ally has gone for hunting dogs actually, though he's getting sheep as well. This really looks like they're trying to go a really super fast farm, because otherwise they would push out more, try to get, well, this buffalo, and or it's an aurochs. Okay, so this is interesting. Depending on what map that is, it's a buffalo or it's an aurochs, though I guess it doesn't really make much of a difference. But okay, he's getting his hunt here. I guess it would be pretty good to take it, seeing as it's so close to space and unharassable, I guess. Anyways, the Ornus player, he seems to be upping quickly. He has all of his oracles in a forward position. Are we seeing a rush incoming? I don't know. It could be. And what is our Zeus player doing? He looks like he's getting a fast temple as well. So maybe some kind of aggression is coming in. But as I said, I'm not really able to predict exactly what's happening now. The Zeus player has four villagers on wood. Possibly it's because he wants to get husbandry quickly. Husbandry is a really good upgrade. He has a lot of sheep, and would just make sense. Oh, I think one oracle. Is it going to fall? I think it's in the corner. It's going to fall. It's always nice if you can pick it off, even if he never had in mind transforming it into a hero. Just removing that scouting is just always very nice. Anyways, Mikhail Victor is going up. Is he building an extra oracle? No, he's not, so I guess that was never his plan. Ornus player don't tend to do that very often anyhow. And does he Well, he scouted a bit of the map, not really that much. He doesn't know of this backward gold mine, which could be important at some point. And yeah, I guess we don't need to check Hell's Ravage scouting because it'll be the same as his Ornn's teammate. What is he doing though? Is he going to the next stage? Not yet. Not yet. He doesn't have the food quite yet. And he's still not going for husbandry. I think he really should. He has so much wood in the bank. Six villagers onto wood now. And I think now anything should be incoming. Athena. So it looks like they might actually try to go for rush, even though he's up very late. Normally, ceasefire is a better god power in a team game just because it affects the whole map, so it affects two armies engaging. And I think it's yeah, just because it not doesn't just prevent fighting from happening against your units, but against all units. It's a better god power normally in team games, but I guess if they have a rush in mind or anything, yeah, Athena is obviously very good. What is income? What increases cavalry and chariot archers hit points? That's a very good relic, and you definitely want to prevent the right player from getting this relic, just because chariot archers are typically the unit of choice for any right player, and cavalry is not bad for Greek either. So I guess it makes sense to get it. This relic where infantry train faster is okay. It's not a game changer. And yes, the Ornn's player has two counter barracks out now. I guess he's just going to try to raid, but I think our two raw players are fairly walled up and don't have any stray villagers. Maybe just here, but he'd have to run past all these towers, and then he could pick up a villager or two without having to worry. But I don't think it'll happen. Okay, the raw player influencer going for a second town center straight away. What did he go up with? Okay, one player went for Bast and the other one went for Ptah. This is interesting. I would have expected both to go for Ptah just to get cheap farms and then to cast double rain. But it seems like no one has gone for farms yet. So, ooh, this could be very nice. Does Mikan, he knows this town center is coming up. He's going to try to deal some damage, but I think he's just a bit late. Maybe he can pick up one villager. Ooh, nice shockwave coming in. Is any damage really going to be dealt? Well, one priest is taken out, but and the Sphinx are there to distract the Turm a bit. But ooh, this is huge. The polar bears, they don't want that town center to go up, do they? And but I think now it really should be going up, and then his villagers are safe. No, don't focus on the polar bears, just a bit more. Wow, this is huge. This is what a combination of events that prevents this town center from going up. Well, one Turm of falling now, and the Sphinx, even though they're myth unit, they can tank a bit of hero piercing attacks, and he should really have taken care of those of those polar bears. Those polar bears might be the game changer. This is crazy. Who would have thought? And now more Turm are coming in. I don't think this town center is actually going up, despite it being at basically 99%. And one Turm of falling, the other Turm of, well, the heroes are all on low hit points. Is the town center going up now? Quick, 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 quick. It's not going up just because there's a little bit of damage dealt there. And a town center always has to be full HP before it can go up, unlike other buildings. Our Zeus player, where are his buildings? Okay, they're somewhat forward. He did go for a second town center himself, but he does have some units out now. Yes, this town center will be prevented. What are our two other rot players? What is. Okay, so Influenza just. Well, I guess he gave up on that town center. He got some farms with the Pitar upgrade, which is very nice. It makes it very cheap, much cheaper. But he lost, I don't know, four or five villagers. He has this gold that he doesn't, well, he's not able to use properly. And which is a pity. He still ha doesn't have any units out or anything. So that was really nice harass by Mikhail Viktor. Very lucky that he got there just in time. And yes, no, our Moe's Cameron did go for his second town center, and he's trying to mine offensively, but I don't think that will happen. He is going to maybe lose his pharaoh. No, I think he should be able to get away. Okay, the first wave of rain coming in, the other Ra player, Moe's Cameron, should try to get. How much gold does he have? Yes, should try to get some farms out and just try to take advantage of the first rain, because he knows that he can cast his own rain afterwards. And yes, I think this is going to be the double rain that I was talking about that can be very powerful. And the other players really don't want to get out farms that early. So in the meantime, there's some raids going on. There's no hero here, so the Sphinx can really deal a lot of damage. And yes, but I guess it's the only units they have out, so they're forced to do a lot of damage with their strings. Otherwise, bad things can happen. Though no villagers are really exposed. Maybe no villagers are exposed at all for Mo, and Influenza doesn't have any villagers exposed either. Easy going for Spearman, I guess he is. Spearmen do pretty good against Hippocon, or they do well against Hippocon and decent against Terma. So I guess it's a decent unit to make, seeing as it's either Terma or Hippocon that he's going to be facing. And yes, I'm surprised Demo didn't go for his own personal reign. I mean, he wants to get it out before the opposing team has a chance to get farms. Because if everyone benefits from the rain, it's just not worth it. You want to be able to, benefit yourself and make sure your opponent doesn't benefit. I mean, your opponent gets and your allies get a smaller boost, but they still get that boost. So you want to make sure that. Oh, is that four Sinks? A lot of Sinks. They're a very nice unit if you can mass them, and as you always have a priest. Well, you should always have a priest around so you can heal your Sphinx and practically never use a unit. And if you can do that, it's very nice. Ooh, the Terma running through the base, taking a lot of damage. But I guess it was necessary. He really had to prevent. Ooh, very nice use of Shifting Sands, preventing this army to. Well, basically get destroyed. I don't think anyone would have made it out alive. And he even took, I think, a Hippocon or two with him. So this was very nice. Yeah, the Sphinx coming to help out now. Hell, while putting on some pressure, he's taking town centers. He's taking this forward town center, which is very nice. But he has farms out now as well. At least some. He's trying to get some in before the rain expires. Very nice, and that's why I said you needed the rain much earlier. Though Mo is going for a lot of monuments. I think he wants to go for really a lot of Sphinx. He has them on auto queue, and Sphinx are very nice. Combined with Slingers, it's a very good combination against Atlanteans, just because you can snipe the hero Terma, and yeah, and when there's no heroes, well, Sphinx can really do take care of everything. But you need your Sphinx to be in the fight if you want to have success with this. So, Hell with a quite a nice army, and I guess he's keeping Influenza in check. And yeah, these Terma are preventing Mo from getting forward gold, but now with the Sphinx around, I think he should just retreat, because even though there's not that many Sphinx slingers left, these Terma, they do okay against hero Terma and great against the normal Terma. So yeah, he's retreating wisely, and Hell is trying to, well, I guess you can just take out this barracks. Might as well. If he doesn't have anything else better to do, and he really doesn't, maybe he could try to put some pressure on here, but then he would leave this town center unprotected and influence having a siege. Siege works out now. I think that's possibly not a good choice. And yeah, it doesn't seem like he's losing anything, taking some damage on the Sipican. But those 75 gold destroyed by taking out a barracks is possibly worth it. Though I think now a Hippocon has fallen, and this one does look very low on health as well. In the meantime, the Ornus player has upped to heroic. He is trying to put. Well, he's trying to defend against the Sphinx, really, though against the fortress. Two palaces, sorry, they're called palaces. He's not really going to be able to do anything, even with Sphinx. And now that there is a bird out, they're just so good against, well, anything really, especially myth units. So I would say he could probably stop building Sphinx now. And yes, though he might as well need to build units, and Sphinx are still a good unit to have just to defend this position. And yes. Influenza is still just on one town center. You wanted to go for a quick town center, and now he's never got it just because of those polar bears, which is pretty crazy if you think about it. Mo is on full population, but he's still classical and he's a long way away from heroic. What about Hel? Hel is going up now, and he's going up through Apollo. Apollo, a very good choice, just because you can move around from this side to the other side. You can double team here. And if ever you get pressured on your side, you can just move back. And you can have your ally move back as well. This could be game deciding, just because it's such a good god power in team games. And yeah, it's good enough in one-on-ones, but it's just really good in team games. And I would say that the Hell's team does already have an advantage, because Hell has a fourth town center, and he doesn't really look like he will be in trouble anytime soon. And yeah, I don't know how Influenza can really get himself out of there. I mean, he's going to get his Son of Osiris bolted if he ever went to Mythic. And I guess he's just going to have to ho I think he's possibly should just hope to defend, and hope that the Ra player is going to that Mo is going to be able to take care of the Atlantean player Mikhail, just because Atlanteans are really bad in late game, and in late game Ra should always win against Atlantean. But if a Zeus has four town centers and you only have two, it's not easy, just because Zeus is very good. What happened here? How did oh what did I miss here? This is Influenza I'm looking for. Did he drop some? He must have dropped some siege towers. And almost managed to take out this town center, but not quite. And he's going for another drop with just one siege tower. Is he going to be able to take it down? I think he will. I think he will. And is he going? He's not going to be able to save it. He took out the town center. I don't know how many siege towers he lost. Probably a lot. So no, but I think it's worth it. It's always worth taking out a town center. And though he doesn't have the army to really control this position now. Did he just delete something? Did he just delete something? I don't think. I think he deleted something. But maybe it wasn't the building that was fully constructed yet. Yeah, I don't think he has the strength to really control this town center. Especially because if he tried doing that, Hell could always just use the underworld passage and have his ally come to his rescue. Though, yeah, Moz did some work with his Eclipse. He managed to push his opponent back. He is going to tower up this gold mine and, yeah, be fine, have another gold mine for at least a bit longer, which is very nice. Ooh, a lot of destroyers coming in. He's going for this town center. Influenza only has one town center, and he won't be able to save this. I mean, he should start. He's trying to go for the upgraded town center. Not a particularly useful tech, if you only have one town center, you typically want to have more. It's better just to take a second town center before you get this technology. And also, while this is unlucky, it prevents you from getting more building units such as mercs while you're getting attacked. Okay, wow, this was a nice diversion. And I guess now the Zeus player can just take this town center, no problem. And so far, not much has been lost for the Atlantean player. Just has the medium upgrade and the first piercing armor upgrade. And I think he's going to prevent this town center from going up again. And yes, Hell is up now to Mythic. And okay, though he has to face the Sphinx raiding, they really need to be raiding everywhere, I guess, just because they are at a very big disadvantage now. And maybe it's the Sphinx raiding, like we saw in Ghostlake's game, maybe they can come back. Well, they took out Colossus, which is very nice at the cost of losing a Sphinx. The Sphinx is obviously so much cheaper. And okay, this town center is going to go up. And the mercs are coming in now, and though they should be aiming for these destroyers, otherwise he's going to lose this town center again. And on this side, Mo does seem to be doing very good. He does have an army here. He could make a push for this town center. Is he finally up to any? Yes, he's in heroic now. He can try to deal some proper damage onto these palaces, though I would suggest he just tries going mythic and then try doing some pressure with catapults. Otherwise, he'll just lose way too much, because two fortresses and a town center, even if it's an Atlantean one, just are going to deal too much damage to your siege towers and units that are there to defend the siege towers, I guess. Okay, more destroyers coming in. Poor Influenza is getting attacked from all sides. Which seems really to take its toll on his eco and army size and everything really. He's getting up an extra mid golem defense. I don't think this is necessary, just because the attack came in twice now, and I don't think it'll actually come in again, just because it's not. I think I would just gamble on the fact that he won't. Yeah, he won't do this again, and he's not. He's not. He's engaged in other fights here. He has to fight Mo, and Mo is heroic now. So if he were to send his whole army across the map, Mo would be able to punish it now that he has siege towers. But I guess an extra mid gold just for more production can never be bad. And oh, like a two-pronged attack, the Deterrent Gate, which is always. Well, it's always very annoying, really. And Hell's army coming in now with the very cheap upgrades. Yes. From Hephaestus, they're there to deal some damage, I guess. The Deterrent Gate does come down. I think he should just focus with his Hippocoon just entirely on the mid goal and just not care about anything else, and just have the Toxodos and the other ranged units take care of whatever units are running around. Here, on the other hand, Mo is defending, and I think he should be fine. He doesn't have that many units out, but he's at full population. And oh, Mikael going for Titan. This is going to be troublesome, because they're already on the defensive. And while Ornnos is pretty bad in late game, if he has a Titan out, he's actually okay. Just because Titans are pretty overpowered, especially if you don't have a proper economy yet. And Mo trying to build on the side, build some siege towers or catapults, and try to pressure here. But he was caught up before anything could happen. So that's a pity. Ooh! I missed this just 2 seconds ago. Hell did go for a sneaky Underworld Passage, and he's going to try to take out this town center, and I think he will, and he's probably going to send villagers in here as well, and he will take this town center, and he'll probably take this town center as well. And there's nothing that really can know. The units are coming in. Are there any villagers from Hell coming through? No, not yet. It doesn't look like he wants to take this town center yet. Maybe he just wants to focus on dealing damage first. And I hear nothing interesting is happening yet. And yeah, if he can take out this town center, he would have dealt a lot of damage. And okay, he's using restoration just because he wants to continue this push a little longer. And ooh, careful there, you're going to lose your underworld passage. This would be a pity, because then all your units would basically be lost. And you need villagers here just to repair this, and then maybe take the town centers later on. And yeah, I think it's going to go down, but the damage dealt is very big. I'm not sure that even without reinforcements, I think this Zeus army with Champion Myrmidon, and which seem more or less fully upgraded, they're going to deal a lot of damage, even against two armies. And yes, it will take some time for the Ra's to take care of this. And in the meantime, the Titan is coming in. Hell's Ravage is probably building up again on the other side, and he's going to try to pressure here, and yes, as I said, see, they're still fighting. He just with all these nice upgrades and the Colossi, which are very overpowered against Egyptians, and some Melopolis, which are upgraded as well. He's just really doing a lot of damage and just making it hell for the for the Ra team. The Titan coming in, I think it's going straight for the town center, disrupting the economy. Yet once again, he doesn't even want to bother with the units. Just go for the town centers and put them even more behind. And the Colossus still around, still preventing both town centers from going up. He's probably going to take out this mid goal as well. And yeah, the pressure is coming in on this side now. Colossi, Myrmidon, even, well, their own Hippocoon. And yeah, now we're seeing a unit that we typically never see, Contarius. They're really the worst cavalry unit in the game, I think. And but I guess against an Axeman Slinger combination, they probably do have their use. And yeah, Moose Tavern is Cavern is also losing, and doesn't look very good for the Ra team. I think this should really be GG, just because fully upgraded Zeus, as opposed to a heroic 1 TC Ra, isn't very good. And this town center was saved for now, but this mid goal is going down. Well, there's still two mid goals here, but I think these two Colossi are enough to take out this town center, and Bellerophon can, well, kill everything else that's running around like he always does. And yeah, so just because of those two polar bears here in the beginning, they prevented that town center from going up. And the Ra player had a nice booming strategy with two reigns in mind, and that would have really gotten them such a good food boost. And they probably could have gone very quick, very fast heroic with multiple town centers, or very fast mythic, and they could have really done a lot of yeah, they would have had a lot of strong units out very quickly and could have pushed the booming Zeus, or just fought off the harassing Oremus very nicely. But because of that town center that never went up, all of their strategy went down the drain. And when you have a strategy in mind, it doesn't work out at all, then readjusting is always difficult. And yeah, so they never got back to the game. Anyways, I hope you like this one, and Chapolin out.